Welcome to Touch Technology Review. Today, I'm going to show you how to add custom graphics to iMovie. I'll demonstrate how to create graphic layouts using Keynote, which is a free application that you should already have installed on your computer. If you don't have it by any chance, just head over to the App Store and you can download it there absolutely free. Once you create the graphics you need, I'll show you how to bring them right into iMovie and work them directly into your edit. The process I'm going to show you today will be on the OS X version of iMovie, but if you only have an iPhone and want to do the same, you can follow along and do it all on the iOS versions of Keynote for iMovie. So what kind of graphics can you make in Keynote? Well, just about anything. Even though Keynote is kind of Apple's equivalent to the Microsoft PowerPoint application, which has primarily been designed to create presentations, it can really be put to good use to create graphic layouts and animated slides that you can very easily use in iMovie. You can create fully customized titles, transition pages, chapter slides, call to action elements, and even stunning 2D and 3D graphs to display statistical information. In today's tutorial, I'll create three examples so you can follow along and apply these techniques to get any type of graphic layout into iMovie. In the first example, I'll create a fully customized title screen with a unique font and background and apply some animation to it. Then I'll create a 3D graph and finally an illustration that could be used to explain a concept or complement your video in any way. To begin the tutorial, let's open up Keynote and pick a theme. The first screen that appears is choose your theme. And this is where you can select the overall theme for your project. And each theme will have its own set of graphics and transition styles to suit a particular look and feel. These can range from minimal styles to bold, editorial, portfolio, craft, and textured themes. For this first demonstration, where I'll show you how to create a title animation, I'm going to select the showcase theme. When you select your theme, you should be presented with the default template. You can add new slides to your presentation by clicking on the slide menu and adding additional slides. And you can change the style of that slide by clicking on that slide that you created and selecting the Change Master option on the right-hand side. And then you can select the layout style that you'd like to use for your particular graphics. For this example, I'm going to stay with the basic title slide, which has a multicolor background and two text fields already on screen, ready for me to modify to suit my requirements. So I'm going to tap in the first text field and change that from presentation title to video production. And then in the subtitle field, I'll tap on that and change that to composition and lighting. Now I'd like to change the color of the typography. So on the right-hand side in the text box, I'll go and change the text color from black to white. And then I want to change the alignment of composition and lighting to right-hand justified. And then I'd like to change the font size of my main title so that it expands out across most of the screen. And then I'll resize the subtitle so it's larger to match the overall composition. And now I'm going to click on the Style tab on the top right-hand corner and add a reflection to my title. Then I'll move the main title up a little bit higher and move around the subtitle until I get the composition that I'm looking for. Now that that's complete, I'm ready to animate my title. So in order to do that, click on the Animate tab in the top right-hand section of the screen and then add an effect. Let's start with the main title and we'll try and preview a couple of options until we find the one that we're looking for. And now that I've tried a few, I think I'll use the anvil effect for the main animation. And then I'll click on the subtext and add a different animation to that for a bit of variety. I'll try a few different options here from orbital to pop, swoosh. Twist and scale. Drift. Compress. Appear. Fade and move. Fly in. So I'm pretty happy with the appear animation, but rather than animating the whole object by itself, I could either select to animate it word by word or character by character. So I think for this example, I'll have it animate out one character at a time. So now that that's complete, we can go and preview the animation. But just before doing that, let's click on the document icon on the top right-hand corner and select the option to automatically play upon open and select the presentation type to self-playing. And then we can go and preview the animation by clicking on the play button at the top of the screen. And provided that you're happy with the way the animation appears, you're ready to export this out as a movie, ready to be imported back into iMovie. So in order to do that, click on the File menu, click on Export To, and then click on Movie. And you can either select to export all slides if you've built an animation across multiple slides, or you can select the individual slide that you've animated. And here you can also change the duration of the animation between each slide or each build. So I'm going to leave this one to 2 seconds between each build. And then if necessary, change the resolution to either 720 or 1080p, depending on the resolution that you require. And then select the next option to export your movie. Give your movie a title and then export it to the desired location. In this example, I'll just export it out to my desktop. And now I'll open up iMovie, click on the Media tab, and import that movie directly into my project. Drag it onto the timeline. I can position it anywhere on the timeline, at the end, over the top of an existing video, or at the beginning. And then I could even apply a transition in between the title and the next video clip. Tap on the play button to preview. And by doing that, we've just added a unique custom animated title into iMovie. Now let's take a look at how to add an animated 3D graph into iMovie using Keynote. Once again, we're going to open up Keynote, but this time we'll select a different theme for the graph animation. I'm going to use a gradient theme for a modern minimal look. I'd like to change the color of the default gradient. So in order to do that, we'll click on the format icon to the top right-hand corner of the screen, and then we'll select the background option. I'll go with a standard light to dark gray gradient, and I'll also change the angle of the gradient just to give it its own unique look. Now I'll go and add my title into the title field. I'll tap on the title field and enter my text. For this example, I'm going to be showing a comparison between iPhone and Samsung sales. I'll now add my graph by clicking on the graph icon in the top section in the middle of the screen. I'll add a standard 2D bar graph to start with. I'll include the legend option by ticking on the legend checkbox to show both mobile phones. And I'll click in the text field in order to label them. So we have iPhone 12 Pro in the blue on the left and Samsung S21 Ultra in the green on the right-hand side. And then I'll click on the edit graph data in order to enter my actual figures of sales for the iPhone 12 Pro and Samsung S21 Ultra. We'll need to add a few zeros on the end in order to be more realistic. By the way, this is just mock data that I'll be using for the purpose of this demonstration. So we'll keep adding in those zeros and you'll see the graphs will change accordingly. If you are using this for a particular project and you have this data already compiled in an existing Excel or numbers document, you can simply copy and paste that data into the graph data cells that you're seeing on screen right now. So now that I've entered all my data, I'm ready to change the graph style. We're going to change from the 2D view to a 3D graph. So in order to do that, click on the graph type option on the right-hand side and we'll change to the 3D column design. And then I can move the graph on a 3D axis into the position that I'm looking for, which is kind of on a 45 degree angle. And we can select between a number of different 3D graph styles from the column, stack column, bar, stack bar, line, area, stacked area, and 3D pie. But I really like the look of the 3D column graph, so I'll go back and select that for my final option. I can change the font color. under the graph and to the right-hand side by clicking on the font and then changing the color under the Axis Labels menu. And I can even add a drop shadow to ensure that the font stands out a little bit better. And that pretty much concludes the layout of my graph data screen. Now we can click on the Animate tab on the top right-hand corner of the screen, and we can choose to animate the title and the graph separately with different animation styles. Click on the play button on the top of the screen to preview the animation. And then I'll click on the document option on the top right-hand corner of the screen. Select the slideshow to automatically play upon open. And then the presentation type will be set to self-playing. And now we can export the movie out. You can change the duration of the animation after each build, or if you've grouped them all as one, as I've done, you can simply leave it as a 2-second transition. Change the resolution to the desired output, either 720 or 1080p. Select the next option, label your movie, and export it out and save it onto your computer. For this example, I'll save it onto the desktop. And now I'll open up iMovie, go to the Media tab, import the new graph movie I just created in Keynote, and add it to my timeline. And now I'm going to show you how to put together a graphic layout using the shape elements that come inside Keynote, along with a photographic image and some titles, in order to build a chapter screen that we can use to go from one scene to the other in iMovie, or to open up a video with a title scene. So in order to mix this one up a little bit, I'll choose yet another theme style, this time from the textured options at the base of the screen. I'll select the Renaissance theme. As you can see, we get a green textured background as our default slide with a kind of vintage paper overlay, which could be ideal for travel videos, craft, vlogging, or anything of that nature. So let's begin by adding a shape to the layout. We'll click on the shape icon on the top of the screen. There's a whole range of illustrations you could choose depending on what you're looking for. I'm going to select the world globe for my layout. When you first place it on the screen, it's rather small. So in order to make it the size that you want, simply click on the right-hand corner and drag it out until it's the right size, and then place it in the position that you'd like it to appear on screen. Now I'm going to add some media by clicking on the media icon on the top of the screen, and I'll add a photo. For this example, I'm adding a photo of the Taj Mahal. And the nice thing about this theme is that it automatically applies an image style to the photo that you add to your layout. And if you like, you can click on the style tab in the right-hand corner and change the appearance of the border around the photo, or you could simply leave it as is with the default setting. Now I'm going to add some titles by clicking on the text element. I'll add my main title at the top. Let's call that India. I'll change the font size and I'll drag it into the correct position. And now I'll add my subtitle by clicking on the text option again. And I'll call this Taj Mahal. And if I like, I can change the color of the subtitle, change the font size, even the font style if I choose, and move it into the correct position. Now that I'm happy with that layout, I'm just going to go and grab one more object by clicking on the shape option again. And this time I'll select the compass icon. I'll change the color by tapping on the style tab, changing it to orange. And now I'll position that over the region that I'm trying to highlight on the globe, which of course is India. And now that you've completed the layout, you're ready to create an animation over the elements on screen. You can either choose to apply an animation to each of the elements one at a time. You could animate India in first, then the photographic image, the subtitle Taj Mahal, and then the globe. By clicking on each element, clicking on the animation option, and selecting the desired animation for each element. They could all be the same, or you could choose a unique animation for each. If you prefer, you can animate the whole group together by clicking on Shift and selecting the elements that you'd like to form the group, right-clicking on them, and selecting the option to group them. And then when you apply the animation, it'll be applied to all of the objects that you put into the group. So for this example, I'll put all of the objects on the left-hand side of the screen into a group, and then I'll put the globe and the compass into another group. So I'll end up with two animations. The first will be on the objects on the left-hand side of the screen, and the second will be on the globe on the right-hand side of the screen. I'll go with the anvil animation on the left-hand side and the lens flare on the right-hand side. Then I can tap on play to preview my animation. If you'd like to change the order in which the animations appear, simply click on the object or group, and then in the build-in tab in the right-hand corner, change the order drop-down menu item. Select the order in which you'd like that item to appear. And once I'm happy with that, I can click on the document option on the top right-hand corner of the screen. Make sure it's set to automatically play upon open. Make sure the presentation type is self-playing, and I can change the duration of the transitions and my builds. In this section here, I can go from 5 seconds down to 2, and the builds could go from 2 seconds down to 0.5. Once you're happy with that, click on export. Movie, make sure it's set to self-playing. If you've created more than one slide for a sophisticated animation, click on all, or you could select to export one slide at a time. Click on next and then give your movie a title. Export it out to the desired location on your computer. In this case, I'll save it to my desktop. And now I'm ready to open up iMovie, go to the media tab, import it, and add the new animation to my timeline. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit me up with a like and consider subscribing to the channel so that you're notified of up and coming video releases. And if you have any questions on the content you've seen today, feel free to put them in the comments box below. See you on the next one. Bye for now.